Hey, Jonathan here. So today we're going to learn how to 3D print in 5 minutes for architects. Let's do this. Let's jump into the tutorial right in. Now you should be able to import the STL model that you have exported from somewhere else. So now that we have them, we can grab the file and put it on the 3D editor, or you can also go to File, Import STL. What we're going to do now is to set up the three main settings you need to check when you begin. First one is right printer, then the right material, and then the right preset. Let's start with the printer. You go and look for the button printer. So on the drop down menu, you should be able to pick the one you have. Then we're going to check the filament, which I always use PLA. Then we are going to add a brim. So for this, you go to the print settings, skirt and brim, and then you go with the skirt height. I would go only with one height. I would go for 30 millimeters or 50 millimeters, like very far from the object. And then the loops, I would go for 5. Now we go back and we go to the print, and then we can see that line that goes around it, which is essentially the first part the printer is going to print. If we go ahead and lower the layers, exactly. Second thing I want to show you is about the infill. Sometimes we do not need, in architectural design, we do not need so much infill, which is all those 3D printed parts inside of the area that you see in red marked right now. Now go to the infill and just go and scroll that all the way down to 0. Then you slice again, and now we can check what happened when essentially we now have a print that it's way faster than before. It's only one hour 50 minutes, and before that it was like 4 or 3 hours. So that's what we're winning here. And then the last thing we can also optimize is that floor, that bottom first layer, takes a long time to print. Now to take that out, let's go to print settings, layer and perimeters, and then the bottom we go to 0, and then we can slice again. Now that we're going to see a different problem, which is the walls are too thin and they might detach from the building plate. And this is when I want to show you another important element of 3D printing, is just a check mark that you can add straight away and then reslice. And that essentially is going to add more surface area to that very thin wall. And that's it. Now we export the G-code, and that G-code we can put into our machine. And now we're going to show you a quick time lapse as we print this very simple design that we did at the beginning. All right, so in 3D Journey, you can find a full stock of videos to learn 3D printing in Prusa Slicer and Ultimaker CUDA. You can find the courses where you can learn basic skills, supported by exercises which will give you practice in the steps it requires to create a 3D model and to subsequently 3D print. Then you can also further your knowledge using the tutorials, where you can practice by creating 3D models that are going to teach you the main tools of 3D printing. That way you can consolidate what you learn in the quick exercise. Now, the goal is not only to understand 3D printing, but also how to create a really good looking model without spending too much time on it. Often it is not required to have a fully detailed model, but just one that can express the spatial idea you have in your architectural project. All right, so since the biggest question of technology for architectural design is what can we use this for when it comes to 3D printing, I have personally worked to develop many, many ways we can use it for architectural design based on the advanced level of the project itself. So in this graph, you can see, for example, how the scale goes from 1 to 2000 all the way to 1 to 1. Depending on the scale where we are, we can use, for example, when we do a conceptual model, urban studies, which move from 1 to 1000 to 1 to 100, site models, which are 1 to 500. Then you can also move on to floor plans, facades, and even a section. So when it comes to 3D printing, it's also important to change, to understand the difference between representation and interpretation when it comes to, for example, three projects from three different firms for the same plot, where we see how, depending on the intention of the design, you want to draw the attention of the viewer to the horizontal facade in this case, to the main entrance in this case, or to the fact that it's just a very simple box on this case. So you have the power to drive the internal conversation of the viewer. Now, if you want to see more of this, do not hesitate to check out our website, where you can get access to this and many, many, many other videos, which will equip you with more skills to develop your architectural project. Thank you, and see you in the next one.